Oh, broads, we are about to take you on a wild, weird, wacky, crazy, fun, intense, passionate journey. But before, I needed to make sure there's a little asterisk here. And I think we said it 100 times in the episode, but you know I have to say it again. We are not experts, nor are we professionals. Are we professionals of anything? Craig is a professional comedian. I don't know if Bekah and I are professionals at anything, but we're definitely not professionals in this category, nor experts, nor are we professors of conspiracy. We are just having a grand old time. We are laughing. We are joking. We are getting scared. We are feeling passionate and intense about a couple topics that we will go off on. But my goodness, these are our opinions. And for the love of God, please do your own research before you believe anything that we've talked about here or joked about. Oh, I hope there is a lot of satire in this episode, and we just pray that you get some of it, but also a lot of passion too. I don't know, it's all over the place, but we hope you enjoy it. And again, not professionals, do your own research. Maybe this is a good episode to pour a glass of wine to, or whiskey, or just, if you don't do any of that, relax, put on your cozies, put on your tinfoil hat, and let's get into it, broads. And for those of you watching on YouTube, hello. Hello, YouTube watching broad. How are you? Thank you for watching on YouTube. Wanted to let you know before you get into this that there were some crazy camera malfunctions during the filming of this episode. Now, was it because of massive heat waves that we weren't prepared for in Los Angeles that cut power to all sorts of things? Maybe, but what seems more likely to me is that the government doesn't want you to know what we're about to say. They were listening all along. Maybe it was the birds. They're cutting off our power. So before you start watching this, there's going to be some weird random cutting out of the cameras at certain points. There might be some weird glitches. It's going to be a roller coaster. And thank you for coming on it with us. But just wanted to give you that heads up before we dive into this episode that isn't going to have any sort of filming for the first about 6 minutes. But then it'll start again. Don't worry. Love ya. Let's get into it.
And welcome to another episode of Chatty Broads with Bekah and Jess.
Well, how is everyone today?
I'm well. Like, I'm foil on my head.
We're gathered here today to talk about some serious topics. We have our foil on, and we have our Craig on.
Aluminum. Aluminum. It's good for your armpits.
He's back, baby.
Craig is back.
We're all special.
We are, and you know what's so crazy? We were talking as soon as Craig came into the home. The last person who has been in this home with us before the lockdown was our episode with Craig.
It
was
Bless up.
You were technically in our quarantine circle.
Thank you.
Yep.
Oh God, I hate this quarantine. Remember when we thought it was going to be 2 weeks? Remember that? I was like, oh, 2 weeks, guys. I'll be back to doing stand-up. I'm going nuts.
Guys, I still think it's only been 2 months of quarantine.
Yeah,
and then yesterday I had to calculate the months and realized it's been five.
It's
five
bad.
Months. Five it's, months.
What happened?
I don't
My
know.
My cat is sick of me. The cat doesn't like me anymore.
Could you please leave, sir? Sir, could you please leave?
It's been... Here we are.
Oh, fuck.
I mean, I remember when we started the last episode, the last one you were on, and you were talking about how the COVID is for pussies.
Yeah.
And how it's going to be over.
I went a little hard on that. I kind of regret that. Lost some followers of that one.
Definitely.
I was like, oh, well, because I'm just like,
clip it.
Dude, everything ever. Ebola, you're gonna die. Killer bees, you're gonna die. Everything's gonna die. So after 12 of them, I'm like, fuck off.
Murder hornets.
Yeah.
Murder hornets, you're gonna die.
Right.
And even this shit, like, yeah, I know it's real. I'm not that crazy, but...
We just had Michael Yo on Tuesday. He almost fucking died.
Yeah, he did. He's a good friend of mine. Yeah, it was very sad.
We know Michael because of Craig.
I laugh. He almost died. No, I love him. I'm glad he's... I know it's real, but also, like, you know, 99.3% of people heal. Yeah. Why aren't we focusing on building our immune system up and taking vitamins and eating organic produce instead of death, 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 count, count, count?
Por que no los dos? You feel me? You know? Why can't?
Beck and I are going to do both. We're going to go. We're going to get some real estate out in the middle of nowhere, and we're going to be in our farm.
Oh yeah, you're after welcome we had to that come. Episode with Jessica Lignado.
Mm-hmm.
In Lotto. I always want to call it Lignado. Anyway, she has a cool last name. I'm pretty convinced that LA is not the place to be when shit hits the fan, and it's already hitting the fan.
It never is, though. It's just
New York is worse, though. Yeah, I think we can all agree.
Yes.
Because of the movies, New York is always worse.
And then, I don't know. It gets pretty bad in the Bay and in LA in movies. And we don't really have natural water sources here. And there's a lot of fire paths.
That's true.
And then New Yorkers make fun of us for our
earthquakes, though. That's real bad. Like, that will just ruin their whole city if there's a big earthquake.
And the North could just cut us off of water. And we'd be like, hey, guys.
Well, that's true.
Well, the earthquake's going to come ripping through here, too.
New York is so dense.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm glad I live in an old building then, full of termites. It's fantastic.
Dude, my house too. My house is falling apart at the seams.
I mean, if you're going to go.
Yeah, it's like, just take me in the beginning.
Just a quick.
You know, also, we're going to need alternate forms. I'm glad Grayson just got a bike thing for Ruth, because we're going to have to bike and scooter out of Long Beach. No way we're going to get anywhere on the 405.
Yeah.
I need to learn how to ride it. I need to learn how to ride a bike.
Is there a bike path that long?
He doesn't know how to bike.
You don't what?
I don't know how to ride a bike. So I'm going to have to learn.
Are you fucking shitting me?
No, she's not.
Are you an orphan? What happened over there? My dad's an asshole and I still know. Sorry, Dad.
Sorry, Dad. I was all about that blade life. I bladed everywhere and I rejected a bike.
Mm-hmm. You guys will get out of LA fast with that.
Yeah, you could go anywhere.
Can Ember rollerblade?
Ember can barely walk.
She'll dance her way out of this town.
That's true.
She'll sing and dance. She'll be like, how is she ahead of us?
I feel like somehow...
How did she get on top of the mountain? Look at her roar. She's good.
I feel like somehow she'll stay put, we'll leave, and she'll become like the gang lord of the city. And she's just bossing everybody around. People
she
are bringing
would.
Her shit.
She has like, a whole fleet of dogs and cats behind her.
She would be Danny McBride in This Is the End, the
yes,
leader. That
yes.
got a little dark. I'm sorry I called your daughter Danny McBride.
No.
Just jokes.
We call her that every day. It's actually her middle name.
Well, we brought you here today, Craig, to talk about some serious shit.
Well, the fact of the matter
this is actually an intervention.
But I'm sober. I've been tempted. Let me tell you, this pandemic has tested me.
Oh, I bet. Whole. Has that been horrible?
I thought about weed a lot. Even though weed saved my life from narcotics and whatnot, I just...
You said eventually, last time you were on, you said you would
eventually like later.
Smoke weed again. Yeah,
like I just wanted to get out of my apartment and into a home and then like build my empire of podcasts and then smoke some reefer.
Sure.
But it's taken a while, guys. No. But just
buy Craig's merch.
Yes. Loosey Goosey. I just got it made. It's from a bit driving on mushrooms. Mm-hmm. That's why I'm sober. I don't even remember what we're talking about.
You actually said something about before we came into the studio. You said something about a psychic being part of the reason you got sober.
Oh, yeah. So my sister went to a big fancy psychic that was very expensive and does a ton of celebrities. This is way before I was in Hollywood. This was like 10 years ago and 11 years ago. And then I just got arrested for the firecracker horse
debacle
fiasco
police assault incident. Mm-hmm. But then I just wanted it. I go in a hole and hide. And I literally, that happened. I got bailed out by my mama, God bless her. And then I literally went to Santa Barbara to see Snoop Dogg and got a hotel. I was like, I don't want to deal with this. And then
excuse the interruption, Broads. It appears we had some interference.
The government did it.
I don't know if it was the government, if it was birds. I'm not sure what it was.
Our cameras were mysteriously malfunctioning for the past however many minutes.
We have been talking for a hot minute. We have been discussing sobriety. We have been discussing what is going on with the coronavirus. And the government does not want us to talk about this shit.
Apparently.
So they turned our cameras off. We even have a producer who's helping us.
Or is
and
it
yet-
someone on the outside to protect our identities for our own protection?
Was it my Uncle Hector?
his lube got into the camera and it kind of messed with the button, so it didn't really ever turn on.
God, Hector.
Freaking Hector, man.
Bringing it back.
Oh, man. Callback. First episode.
If you don't know it, are you really a fan? That's all I have to say.
And honestly, if you don't know who Craig is, how dare you?
I feel sorry for you also.
Yeah.
Craig is basically part of the Chatty Broads fam.
Well, thank you. Very proud of that.
As you were saying, this psychic.
Okay, so my sister went to a psychic. When a fancy, expensive Hollywood one, and I was living in Lamita. I just got arrested for the throwing firecrackers at police officers on horses. Don't do drugs, guys. Anyways, I literally didn't want to deal with it. That's the kind of person I am. I was scared. I'm crawling a hole kind of guy, and I went to Santa Barbara to see Snoop Dogg as soon as I got bailed out by my mother, God bless her soul. And
Santa Barbara Bowl?
Yes.
Great venue.
Oh my God. Fantastic. So fun. Oh my God.
I miss live music.
He did a tribute to Tupac and Nate Dogg. It was, you know, I was drinking and drugging at that time. So some tears were shed. You know? Oh, Snoop, you get it, man. But anyways, during my sister's reading with the psychic, she was like, I need to talk to your brother. I just kept coming in her reading. And then my sister was like, he's broke. He's a drug addict. You know, and she's like, I'll read them for free, because she had lost a daughter to pills, and I was a pill junkie, and then she read me for free. She's like, you need to get a lawyer or you're going to jail. So I had four charges: assault on an officer, assault on a horse officer. Who would have known that they're an officer too? Anyways, detonation of explosive device is firecrackers, guys. I was just drunk. I didn't mean to throw it at them, is the ironic part. I just threw them on the ground.
They
and
got
then
in the way.
You got in the way of my good time. And then possession of explosive devices, firecrackers. And then she's like, you need to get a lawyer. You need to get sober and you need to go to Hollywood, move there and do stand up. You'll rise up fast.
Shut the fuck up.
I swear to God. And and then I did. Yeah, so here we are, man.
You were just straight up like, okay.
Oh, my
God. I'm very dumb in the sense I do dumb shit like that. Keep in mind, I hate it because people think I maliciously threw firecrackers at cops on horses. Mm-hmm. I was drunk and threw them on the ground and then noticed them. That's how fucking twacked out I was. It was an accident.
The brain wasn't fully operating.
Never been malicious in that sense, because I get a lot of, you know, the PETA who sent me death threats and whatnot. I'm like, you weren't there, PETA. I love cats. I have a cat. I don't remember where I was going with this. What were we talking about?
You listened to the lady.
Oh, I listen. I'm dumb where I do shit like that. But when people tell me stuff, I listen. I go... Because I knew I had it in me, and I'd always wanted to do it from a little kid, but it took strangers telling me to tell me my calling, which was so weird. Like, why did she have to tell me something?
Why can you listen to your mom or something?
Yeah. Well, she told me to, like, go do construction. She's old school Mexican. Get a job. Get a union job. The benefits. I'm like, I don't want to break my back. I already did that, jumping off roofs. Wasted. Anyways, my shoulder hurts. Am I right, guys? What? So I listen to people like that. I several of them. Grant Lyon is a comic buddy of mine. I was doing improv at first because I was terrified of stand up. And he said in much kinder words, but he's like, you got to stop being a little bitch and go grab a microphone. And as much as humanly possible. And I listened. I listened to the people that were higher up and deeper in the game's advice. Which is my strength, because before that, oh boy, I was just me and old Hector in the garage there.
Well, and now here you are. I saw your stand-up. That's why you're here.
Thank you, yeah.
That's so true.
Well, and my bachelor producer friend.
Oh, Bill.
Yeah.
I love Bill.
I just got off the phone with him last week.
Nice. Good old Bill. Yeah. Bill
but Dixon. It was true. It was because you saw his stand-up, and then you called me, and we're like, we got to get Craig on.
Oh, thank you.
And here we are.
I know.
And now stand up.
It's all I have. I can't do it.
And you don't have anything now. I'm
digging in the soil every day.
Sorry, guys. I got to take these sunglasses off. They're killing my temples. Yeah. Did anyone else get headaches?
Yeah, the headache is real right now. But you know what? You
Ray can Bans.
Keep. You but can the fashion keep your, is real.
But also the fashion is just fantastic. But I see that they're doing the drive-up, drive-in shows
which
now.
Which is genius.
Mm-hmm. You know, I'm all for being positive, but...
Was it rough?
Wow. When you do good, they honk at you and flash high beams at you. It made me blind, and I was like,
That's why Craig saw his sunglasses on.
Wait, are you serious?
Yes! I was like, you guys think that's good, but I'm about to fall off the stage. I'm disorientated. Everyone's being so positive. It's awesome. It's awesome. I'm like,
because I bet everyone wants to laugh more than ever. Easiest crowd in the world,
oh,
I'm sure.
God.
Yeah.
But then when they're happy, they just honk and flash in the middle of your set.
Yeah. Oh, God. Yeah. No, the comics are all everyone some heavy hitters. They were like, that was fun. I'm like, are you fucking insane? That was compared to the real thing.
Yes.
That was awful. But. Because of the current circumstances, it was fun. It was amazing. But it's just like, do you guys remember what a
couple months ago?
Yeah, remember the belly room at the Comedy Store?
Yeah.
You remember that?
That was awesome.
That was awesome. Yeah, man. I mean, it's great. Come to the show tonight. Come honk at me.
Do you really have a show?
I have a show tonight and a show tomorrow. That was the first time ever where I did it last night. I was like, you know. Did I really need to be booked on all three?
Wait, we actually need to go to some drive-in comedy, Jess.
I know, we definitely do.
I want to.
I miss comedy.
No. You do. Yeah,
I'm going to double down on that honking. Just let out all my aggression.
I'm just going to lay on it. Through the whole set.
And then you're, and I talk about weird stuff, you know, and I just, in the middle of my set, there's people walking down the sidewalk. Imagine if you... heard
for real, that's weird.
That is very interesting. You're exposing certain parts of yourself to the public that weren't necessarily paying
to hear it. Speaker?
Yeah, imagine if you're walking your dog
or your kid
in a stroller and you just hear, you guys ever smoke so much weed you smoke heroin? You know, and you're like, what the fuck, Magic Castle, what are you doing over there? I thought it was magic tricks. Is that an AA on the loudspeaker? I'm not supposed to say AA. Is that a program? I don't even know the rules anymore. It saved my life. Thank you.
AA did?
Program.
Oh, are you not even allowed to say it?
No. Mm-hmm. The program. A program.
Wait,
program.
What? I'm confused. What do you mean you're not allowed? Who's not allowing you to say it? What's this conspiracy?
No, it's just and here we go. No, it's supposed to be remain anonymous so people can't praise it or give it hate. And it's supposed to, even
so
the
we're
program,
not supposed to know it exists?
No, just like you're supposed to call that a 12-step program.
Interesting.
Anyways, fuck off. Anonymity doesn't exist anymore. They're listening. They hacked the cameras.
Broads, when I tell you that I am literally tearing up just thinking about this company, this app that I'm about to tell you about, I'm not being dramatic, okay? This company changed the trajectory of my daughter's experience with reading and writing and her ABCs. I'm getting emotional in the middle of an ad read. But my sweet daughter, Ember, was really struggling with ABCs, reading, writing, all of that. And she felt really discouraged before the shutdown when she was in pre-K. She was really discouraged because a lot of the other kids in her class were able to do more than her, and she struggled. And even her sweet teachers, they were so kind, but they would let us know that that was something she was struggling with. So Evan and I were doing a lot of research to try to help her. And we'd spent countless hours trying to find different ways to help, and it just wasn't working. And we felt bad that we couldn't help her. But then we discovered Homer. And I am telling you, in mere days, everything changed for Ember. She loved this app. She learned so quickly from it, and her confidence went through the roof. She went from being so discouraged about things to strutting around talking about how she's the best reader, the best girl with her ABCs. And I'm telling you, it's so noticeable that within a week and a half, her teachers were asking us, like, what happened? What did you do? We've seen such an exponential improvement. And I told them, it's Homer. Homer is the proven learn to read program powered by your child's passions. Homer reading combines your child's interests, things that they're excited about, and their current reading level to create a personalized learn to read plan. For Ember, it was all about the animals. She wanted everything to be animal focused, and she loved it. And man, Homer just sucked her in. She was so focused, and it takes a lot for that little one to focus. She was so focused with Homer. And we're talking thousands of kid-tested lessons on ABCs, phonics, sight words, and more, designed by learning experts, enjoyed by kids right at home. And if you have multiple kiddos learning to read, first of all, bless you. Homer has you covered, because one membership comes with up to 4 customizable profiles that grow with your child. As they progress through the reading program, the lessons will become more tailored to their interest and their skill level, which is a surefire way to keep them engaged while learning. Using the Homer reading for just 15 minutes a day was shown to increase early reading scores by 74%. And like I said, the noticeable difference with Ember was extreme. And she absolutely loves the app. And Homer knows that screen time can be a personal decision that varies a lot from family to family, which, by the way, especially right now, we're having to do a lot of screen time, at least in this house. And that's why Homer designed the app to be ad-free, safe, and super easy for kids to navigate and understand all on their own, a much-needed peace of mind for all parents right now. And like I said, I know there's a lot of screen time for a lot of us, and I felt sometimes guilty about it, to be honest. But with Homer, I just see her learning and growing so much using it, and she loves it. I'm telling you, it's one of those things that I can tell you about as much as I want, but until you download it and see your child interact with it, it's just hard to explain how wonderful it is. You can actually try Homer today by visiting learnwithhomer.com/chatty to start your free 60-day trial. 60 days. The only expert-designed, kid-tested app that teaches reading step-by-step. That's learnwithhomer.com/chatty to start your free 60-day trial today. I promise you will love it. Well, Ember is loving her reading and Mama is loving her online shopping. I might love it a little too much, but you know what? One thing I love even more than buying from stores online these days is saving money on those purchases. The best, fastest, most surefire way to save money when you're shopping online is by using Honey at checkout. Honey is the free browser extension that scours the internet like your best friend, searching for promo codes, and then they apply the best ones that it finds in your cart. So basically, it's a necessity, and if you don't already have it, you're missing out on free savings, and who wants that? So far, Honey has saved its 15 million members over $2 billion on everyday purchases at over 30,000 stores online. I mean, those are some big numbers all around. Places like Target, Best Buy, Sephora, all the places you probably shop from already that you're already buying online, especially during these times. All you have to do is install the Honey browser extension. And when you go to the checkout button, a thing drops down and you can click apply coupons from Honey and you watch those prices drop. It almost sounds too good to be true. I thought it was, but I promise it's not. Somehow it's just not. The other day, I saved almost $40 on home good items from Target that I would have bought one way or another. But of course, buying them with extra savings is always the better option, especially right now. I'm trying to save that money, Honey, and I'm saving it with Honey. If you don't already have Honey, you could be straight up missing out on free savings. It's literally free and installs in a few seconds. And by getting it, you'll be doing yourself a solid and supporting the podcast. Get Honey for free at joinhoney.com/chatty. That's joinhoney.com/chatty. Speaking of hacking the cameras, we have gathered you broads here today to go over some serious things. There's been a lot of conspiracy theories that have been rolling around as of late. I don't know if it's because we're all just in our homes more,
fucking better to do,
and we're getting more paranoid for correct reasons.
No, it's because the election's coming up. That's the real reason why.
It's very true. It's very true. And there are some very serious conspiracies that are being brought to the attention. So we thought that we would tap into some of the very serious conspiracies.
The even more, most,
the most serious ones. Mm-hmm. The most serious. Goes beyond all the election. So I think a good one to start off with is that birds are not real.
What?
Okay, I don't understand this one at all. I saw you text me about this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to need you to elaborate.
Birds do not exist.
I saw one on the way in. What are you talking about?
You think you saw a bird.
I've been shit on before.
That's at Venice true, Beach, me too.
Drinking a beer when I wasn't sober.
I'm here to let you know that what shit on you was a government drone, not a bird.
Between, so what, they've implanted them in movies and stuff too?
Between the times of 1950s and the early 2000s, the government genocided over 12 billion birds and replaced them with drones.
There were birds.
There were once birds. And there still are some birds. But for the most part, birds are government drones. And they're watching you
Why
constantly.
Do they need those when we have these?
They already listen to everything.
I held up my phone for audio listeners.
They need more. They need more eyes on you. Think about it. Have you ever actually touched a bird in the wild? They do a lot of staring and not a lot of blinking. It's the cameras. Also, when they fly away, they're going to go recharge.
I believe you.
Yeah. Thank you.
You know, I have wondered why we don't see more dead birds.
What are you talking about? I've seen them. It's terrible.
No,
they're on the flat and on the highway.
Every once in a while, because there are still some real birds.
Think about how many birds there are.
There are
that
so
you
many
see
birds
flying around, but see how. Think about how few dead birds you see.
I saw the worst. I stopped watching documentaries. I just get so sad. But it was about a bird island, and they're all dying because they just eat our plastic, and they did an autopsy.
Or is the government killing them?
Yeah, it's
or
both.
Is it the bird genocide via the U.S. government?
Maybe the birds are like, I've had enough of these people, and they're just kamikaze killing themselves.
But you know what? They don't even need birds because they have like you could put cameras in street lamps and dumb shit like that. That would be way easier.
That's fine.
Unless they need a bird's eye view.
Oh.
You need a bird's eye view. You need it everywhere. You need it everywhere, truly. Okay? And listen, a bird the other day perched right on the corner. My mom has her front door, and that bird is on a little light that's almost touching her front door. That bird heard everything that my mom spoke about. That bird heard my mom's social security number, probably. That bird heard my mom.
Which the government already knows.
The government knows that.
Maybe
that
it's a different government.
How to grow an
maybe
orchid.
It's a private sector. That's
maybe it's a private, or maybe it's a different government.
Russia.
Mother Russia.
Are sending in the birds. How many baby birds have you really seen?
Which, by the way, y'all, I don't know if you know about the real truth about how Russia was super involved in the last election with different internet stuff. Like, Russia, the last election, was putting out propaganda information on both sides. Like, there were Russian bots on, like, Tumblr and stuff like that that were putting out, like, super liberal content and super conservative content as a strategy to try to divide the country and to also dissuade Democrats from voting for Hillary Clinton. And, you know, so people have that thing of, like, oh, there's no good option, which, like, is true. But anyway, they had their hand in the last election, we found out, through internet forums and social media sites. And so what do you think's happening right now?
Hey, guys, it worked.
and it's going to work again.
And it's going to work again. It's probably the birds.
Oh.
Not Smith children. But anyway. Okay, so next.
No, but listen. I'm going to stick to the bird because I would like to talk for a moment about crows.
Okay, Jess made this one up, she told me, so I'm ready to listen.
Well, this is the beginning of a conspiracy that I feel like I don't understand why this isn't talked about more.
Okay.
Okay, and these are facts about crows, guys. Okay. This is not some bullshit that I'm pulling out of my ass.
They've always creeped me out.
Crows are kind of crazy, right? Well, a crow is essentially a flying monkey in regards to intelligence.
Bitch, what are you talking about?
The Wizard of Oz is real?
Yep.
Facts. Wait, what do you mean?
Crows are so smart. All right, I'm going to tell you about crows.
So it's just they got stuck with wings and claws. That's why they haven't gone farther.
Crows recognize human faces.
Oh, I knew this.
Okay, so if you're nice to a crow, they will remember your face and distinguish it from another face. And for instance, there is a small child I read about recently who started to feed crows on a regular basis. The crows bring her presents. Okay. She showed off all her gifts. She's got little trinkets, little earrings that they find.
True. I was about to say, what is her present? A dead rat? No, thank you, Mr. Crow.
No, they're bringing her things like little heart necklaces.
Hey, this is real?
Yes, you can watch. Okay. You can watch it on the BBC. Wow. Yeah. And
I would get a restraining order. I'd be like, don't talk to me or my child ever again.
And listen, crows will also attack. If you help a crow out and they decide to fall in love with you, if you, anyone ever tries to hurt you, there have been reports of when someone got too close to a child that they love, they will dive bomb from the sky and sit on the home and they recognize the face. So when you do something that's not nice to a crow will like haunt and hunt you. Okay.
All right, well, it looks like I gotta feed some crows.
You have to go out and feed the crows.
You're gonna be a bird, man. You'd have seed covering.
You got nothing on me, Hitchcock. Look at this shit. That's what's up.
That's the new army that you need to begin, is a crow army. Because
that's terrifying. Yes. If someone descended upon me with an army of crows,
I'll attach
scary.
Little BB guns to the clock. So fun.
It's super cute. Kind of violent, but super cute.
That's the noise BB guns make, too. Hope you know that.
Pew, 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 pew. There is a scientist called Mars.
They can drop firecrackers on people.
I have a couple left. I love fireworks.
There's a scientist called Mars Love, and they captured crows, tagged them, and released them. And members...
You guys hear that?
There's a cricket in here.
I was like, this is super
loud. It's going to be part of our background
robot
noise.
Robot cricket. They're spying
crickets
on us.
Also don't exist. Members of this team, okay, so they captured the crows, tagged them, and released them. Members of the team wore different masks, and crows would dive bomb and scold people wearing a mask, but only if the mask had been worn by someone who had messed with them.
This is a face mask like we all wear?
No, a full mask.
See, I don't know any other masks anymore besides the
one
that we have to
wear. You're like, this is the only thing I recognize. No, so if Craig fucks with a crow and I wear a Craig mask, they would attack me.
Scary experiment to be a part of.
Yes. They also talk about you. If you think two crows watching you cawing at each other are talking about you, you're probably right. In scientific studies, even crows were never captured attacked scientists. They talk to each other and let them know who's good and who's bad.
What?
Yes. By the way, you guys, this is not conspiracy theory.
They're like, get that motherfucker. The what?
Yes. Yes.
Why aren't we talking about crows more often?
Why are we not talking about crows? Also, they use tools. They will find wires and bend them together.
Little hammers.
Scientists tested whether crows really are this smart. They placed a floating treat in a deep tube, and the crows in the test dropped dense objects into the water until the treat floated within reach. They didn't select the objects that would float in the water, nor did they select ones that were too large for the container.
What the fuck?
They say that they
that's where all the children's toys are going. Like,
the crows.
Where's the little, what? I don't even know the reference. Mike and Me Hammer? What is it called? Huh? I don't know. I was trying to think of the Hammer Company.
I don't know about it.
The children's toys? You guys probably build your own out of wood. Your hip.
Oh.
Tonka
toys?
Truck.
What are toys?
Tonka truck?
You don't know what toys are?
Continue.
What's a toy? Also, they adapt to the human world. Crows have adapted to...
You ever see a crow in a business suit heading to an interview?
I have. What? I wondered, well, who was his agent? What audition are you going to?
Crazy that you mentioned that. I saw a crow the other day driving an Uber. It was fantastic.
With a mask on.
Sensitive enough to wear a mask.
A crow tried to steal Mr. Cat's bow tie. I seen him battling. He's so cute.
Oh, listen, the crow and Mr. Cat might be friends.
I don't know.
He might also go after Mr. Cat, so you might want to be careful about that. But they adapt to the human world. They watch what we do and learn from us. Crows have been seen to drop nuts in traffic lanes so that the cars will crack them open. They will even watch traffic lights, only retrieving the nut when the crosswalk sign is lit.
All right. Are you sure crows aren't robots? What the fuck?
That's what I'm saying, guys. Why are we not talking about crows? Okay. Do with this what you will, but this needs to be talked about more often. We talk about scientists with monkeys and like, oh my God, the monkeys, ooh, the dolphins. What about the fucking crows? And they're everywhere. We're not around monkeys and dolphins all the time, but you know what we are around all the time?
Crows. Mm-hmm. What about dolphins? Did you ever hear the theory where, like, there was a period of time where people gave birth in the ocean and dolphins would help?
Really? Oh, I've seen videos of it. I saw a video of someone giving birth in a pool of dolphins, and the dolphins were like
coming to their aid.
Yeah, I don't know what a dolphin can do with no hands.
Cut the cord.
Isn't that crazy?
That's wild.
That's wild.
But they like didn't leave her side in the video I saw. They're like emotional support animals.
You just did a water birth, right?
I did. No dolphins.
What? No dolphins, no crows. Get out. No.
You'd think a sponsor would have been able to help with that one.
True.
Where are the dolphins?
I guess this doctor was doing a ton of underwater birth, and then he's like, let's try it in the ocean. Let's go to Mother Earth to do it. Sure. And when he tried that, dolphins came and like took over and wouldn't leave the lady's side. Wow. And that's how it became a thing. It was just by accident. They just came, was like, what's up? We got it from here. I'm like, that's amazing.
Well, dolphins are, I'm a little scared of them. I think they're secretly evil. They're too smart. They're the only mammals besides humans who have sex for fun. Well, I'm sure you guys have heard of the story of the woman who was working with the dolphin who would jack him off.
No, haven't heard that one.
You want to hear about
it? Oh my God, I feel sick already.
No, it's actually like when you hear her talk about it, it's not that weird. I swear. I swear.
I'm going to say bullshit.
No. So this lady was part of this like experiment in the 80s where they were like, we're going to teach dolphins how to communicate with us via like letters. So what she had to do is she had to like live in this thing with this dolphin. The dolphin was like in the bottom floor of the water, and she had like kind of like an upper loft area since she obviously couldn't live with the water, but she was with him like all the time. And her focus was trying to teach him how to like press letters with his nose to communicate, you know?
Okay.
And
with his nose or boner?
Well, apparently it was a young male dolphin who was really horny, and basically the dolphin wouldn't focus and would always be trying to hump and rape her. And so she's like, we gotta do what we gotta do so this dolphin will focus. So she just had to manually stimulate him so then he would focus again.
Hey, scientists, get a female dolphin.
For real.
It sounds like Evan when I'm
the problem. You don't have to jack off said dolphin. Get a chick dolphin.
It sounds like Evan when I'm trying to get him to learn how to clean the house better. He gets too distracted. And so I'm just like, I gotta take care of this. Then I'm like, see,
it's only gonna take 45 seconds. So, you know.
These are Clorox wipes. And this is, you gotta see how I'm moving my hand? You move your hand like this. And then see what you got to clean up what you just did. That's too dark. Okay, I'm sorry. Dolphins.
So, yeah.
That's the worst.
Yeah.
It's the worst, actually.
It doesn't really bother me that much.
I feel traumatized.
I'm not saying I want to jack off a dolphin, but it's like,
I'm just kind of like, do we need to know that much about them that we now have to take it that far?
Probably a little too honest.
I think now it's time to start really focusing on crows.
I was going to say, hey, scientists that jacked off the dolphins, you can keep that to yourself.
Yeah, we don't need to know about it.
That's some shit I would do. Be like, oh yeah, that one time when, you know, someone walked in on me, you know, drinking off the dolphin. It's nothing weird. Nothing weird. Now, I have to say on the topic, I don't really know how animal sex works. Like, I don't know how birds have sex with each other.
I actually don't know that either.
Yeah. I know some birds mate for life, and I learned that from the Umbrella Academy. Good show.
The lovebirds. Lovebirds, like, die together.
Wow.
And I think penguins mate for life, too.
Yeah.
And then the daddy
is the one. You guys all went to the theater to see March of the Penguins.
But of course.
Did you?
Yes. I don't remember.
You probably did.
I probably did.
But that shit was depressing.
It was very sad, but it was also very beautiful. I also saw Everest on the IMAX screen after March of the Penguins.
Oh my God, I saw a stupid movie about caves in IMAX. So our senior trip in high school, every year was to the zoo. Uh-huh. Every year was to the zoo. Uh-huh. And then the year
before... That's your senior trip? Like, we went to Six Flags.
Yeah, we went to Disneyland overnight.
That's way better.
Yeah, you went to the zoo.
What the fuck?
We were actually banned from Disneyland. Our school district was. Because someone tried to climb up on the Matterhorn, and so our school district got banned.
Nice.
Was that Craig?
Yeah, I wish.
Definitely could have been. So you guys went to the zoo?
No, I was a junior, and the senior class went to the zoo, and a gorilla or monkey threw shit, and it hit the vice principal in the arm and left a skid mark, and everyone laughed at her and made fun of her, and she was kind of a bitch, and she literally stopped the zoo and changed it to the IMAX, and then we got to watch a bat documentary because a monkey threw shit.
Your senior trip.
Imagine getting shit thrown on you and canceling the school's field trip or changing it. How rude are you? The monkey hit the right target.
A lion has peed on me before and I stayed at the zoo.
The spray.
Yeah, it lifted its tail. I got too close. Lifted its tail, peed all over me, all over my shoes in front of a bunch of people. I was like 13 too, so I was very embarrassed. My white kit's covered in piss. But I am now Dandelion's Bride.
Nice. Yeah. It's, I imagine it smelt.
Who's Bride? Is that the lion's name?
Yes, he
claimed
to me.
Okay, I didn't know if that was a term from a movie or something. It sounds like a movie.
His name was his name was Dandelion, and now we're still dating.
That's a cute name for a cat. Thank
you. Yeah, he claimed me.
Nice.
But I stayed at the zoo. I didn't hold it against him.
I always have mixed feelings about the zoo because, like...
Yeah, it's a dark place, I think.
It is, but then also, it's fun. No, I'm just kidding. That's not what I was going to say. It's sad, but then... Because they're in captivity where they're not supposed to be, and they're bred in captivity. But I also have this thing where I'm like, okay, like in Fresno, we have a really big, beautiful zoo, and there's a lot of kids in Fresno who like never get to see the beach or like never get to see the mountains or snow or the ocean or any of these things. And I feel, and it's like a really affordable zoo. And so I'm sort of like, that's really special that these kids will get to see like a taste of the wilderness and the outdoors, even if it's behind bars.
Well, it
bars.
Can help people become passionate about.
Right. Saving and protecting animals.
I think it
animals.
Depends on the zoo.
Yeah.
If it's like a big luxurious zoo, I'm for it. But most of them seem a little on the low budget end.
Some of the ones that are, is it the San Diego Wildlife Park where it's fully open and the animals roam free? And
that's
that
awesome.
Feels, that
but it's
feels
still
better.
Fucking with like the animals' migration patterns
I know, it's
and
all,
stuff like that.
I feel bad about it, but then I also, I feel very...
What makes me for it is like we ravaged this earth so much that we're killing them that the zoo prolongs their life and keeps them going by breeding them, which is disgusting to think that that's why it's a good thing, you know?
Yeah.
Well, we killed all your family.
Oh, your wild family. That's like if we put you in jail and be like, well, we're continuing Craig's generations. We're in jail.
Yeah,
his children are going to grow
up
in jail.
Bad.
It is. Yeah, that is fucked up. Oh my God. It's just like, sorry that our plastic burned down all of your forests.
Yes. Yeah.
But we're just going to put you in this cage. Oh gosh.
Can we stop chopping down the forest? Have you heard of hemp? Have you heard of hemp?
Yeah. Mm-mm.
It can save
Bamboo.
The world. Bamboo, fastest growing wood on earth.
It is crazy fast growing.
Yep.
We had some bamboo pandas. In our yard. I mean, wow.
More bamboo, more pandas maybe.
No pun intended. So, next theory.
Next theory. This one is very important.
Is this the Avril Lavigne one?
Yes. Okay. We need to talk about
on
the
your
fact
iPad.
That she's a time traveler?
No. Avril is dead. She died in 2003. Okay. And you can look up photos. You can see that the faces look slightly different. But here's the thing. I'm first looking at this. I'm going like, yeah, people's faces change a little bit when you get older. From 2003, sure. Like I look vastly different. Okay. But here's the thing. Before the believed death of Avril in 2003, she found a lookalike. Her name is Melissa. And she lived in Los Angeles.
This is a real thing.
This is them together. The one on the right is the real Avril. The one on the left is the one who looks...
No, this isn't real.
...like Avril. And...
Wait.
And Avril used to use Melissa after she met her because the paparazzi, the celebrity, was so over the top.
Look at this.
The celebrity was so over the top, she became exhausted and she would use Melissa as a distraction with the paparazzi for some shows. When she couldn't, when she was tired.
Man, I love Avril.
Avril's the best. And now, Avril has passed away, and Melissa, because Avril was a machine of a moneymaker for so many companies, early on, Avril was making so much money. She was an icon. And so after she passed, they didn't want that money to die, so they hired Melissa to continue on as Avril, which explains why new Avril would ever think about marrying the singer of Nickelback, because that doesn't feel like something the OG Avril would ever do. Rock. It's not very punk rock.
I mean, I believe it.
Also, let's talk about handwriting. Handwriting doesn't normally change, right? Over the years, not too much. Well, you will see on the left, Avril's handwriting in like 2001, and then you will see on the right Avril's handwriting in 2017, and you will see a large, large difference. One looks like kind of angry scribbles, and the other one looks like, you know,
basic. No, these look similar to me.
Really?
They do.
I don't see it.
Maybe she got arthritis and she just got a little rickety crickety, you know? She's like, ow.
It's definitely a possibility.
Yes. Okay, hold on. I'm looking pretty close.
Now last year met Avril.
It is interesting. Her A's very in bubbly. This one, the little thing goes a little like loopy, doesn't in there. So there's some shifts that I do find interesting. The M's are still very similar.
Craig, would you like to see the handwriting?
I already believe it, so I'm good.
Now, to me, the most interesting is the voice. Okay.
So she hit puberty.
No, because you'd think you'd hit puberty, your voice would get deeper. Original Avril's voice, deeper and huskier. New Avril, higher, more nasally. Would you like an example of this?
Yes. All right. Play it away.
I hope that we don't get flagged.
Oh, yeah. Might get demonetized on YouTube.
Lord help us. This is an ad, so probably get up the ad. It's for Snickers.
This sounds scary, though.
What kind of Snickers is that? Eat us or we'll kill you.
It sounds like people screaming.
Okay. Okay, this is original Avril. Original.
Are those both live performances?
Okay, can you tell that difference?
Yes.
That's a pretty drastic difference. And the first one was young Avril, and the second one was old Avril. Let's listen again. Old Avril. New Avril.
Yeah, that doesn't sound like her.
It does not sound like her.
This is a crazy same theory about the Beatles and Paul McCartney. Mm. And I read a little bit of a book about it, and then I gave up on it.
It is insane that she found a lookalike, and we've seen photos of her and the lookalike together.
Well, that was a Bill Clinton lookalike that made like $1 million a year just doing presentations, talking and sounding like him.
Now that seems real sketchy.
That does.
You have an identical
Bill Clinton looks
president.
Like someone though who probably has like 20 doppelgangers.
Yeah.
He has that kind
Every
of
Every old
look,
white
you know?
Guy yeah, looks exactly, like Bill Clinton.
Exactly.
Now the doppelgangers is an interesting one. Okay, because have you seen all the celebrity doppelgangers from old photos?
Yes,
that's weird.
It's pretty wild, right? Broads, if you're like looking online, you might be able to find
them in old paintings and stuff, right? Yeah. In old photos.
If you literally
like,
just
okay,
look that
Leo,
up.
Okay, Leo, you're a time traveler, bro.
Oh, Jimmy Fallon?
Yeah.
The Jimmy Fallon one is bizarre, okay? And we're seeing everything we're seeing.
Do you have an article on this?
Yes, I will link the article. Broads. Here's you. Jimmy Fallon.
So crazy.
Bekah, Jimmy Fallon.
Wow.
We have, you know, there's the Jay-Z doppelganger. There's the Matthew McConaughey doppelganger.
That one's pretty crazy.
It's pretty strange. And there are so many. And you have to wonder why.
Time travelers. Time is linear.
Maybe we all have crazy doppelgangers, but the thing is when you're a celebrity, you have so many more people who could recognize you potentially.
So that very is true. The thing. You have way more people eyes out for art, photos, et cetera, to be like, oh, this looks like Jimmy Fallon. Not a lot of people know the three of us are in comparison.
Absolutely. And if you believe in reincarnation and energy, like, we're just here to learn lessons and we just keep coming back until our souls are done learning the lessons, and that, and we're just this.
Not to mention, I mean, we've all got the same features more or less. Two sure. eyes, a nose, mouths, a head.
Yeah.
How many different variations?
How many?
How far can we deviate from the similar looking
If you
thing?
Put a baby picture of me and my nephew side by side, we're identical.
Right.
We're fucking identical.
Yeah. Or are we in a simulation and the creators of the simulation just get lazy sometimes?
I read that shit and it fucked me up, man.
Oh, you
scientists literally can't prove that we're not in a simulation.
Can we talk about, okay, you know
and
what?
And I was like, what?
There's lots of things we can't prove,
no,
though.
No, Bekah. Get ready to stay
sorry,
up.
Sorry, my tin hat, four hats slipping.
Get ready to stay up.
The simulation's failing.
Get ready to stay up at night, honey.
Okay, I'm ready.
Here we go. All right. Let's talk about the simulation, all right? So, of course, people believe different
things. Jess,
you're good
at this. You're good at convincing me.
Thank you.
Craig and I are on board all of them.
I don't believe in any of them, but I'm going to fucking convince everybody. Listen, we all have our beliefs, right? So some people believe that there is something divine, whether you're Christian, sure. Muslim, whatever, something divine that created the earth. Some people believe in a Big Bang theory, and here we are. Some people believe that God created the Big Bang theory. In a sense, there is faith that's necessary for all these things, of course.
We can all agree.
But the simulation holds up just as much, if not more, validity proven by scientists than something like divinity or purely a Big Bang theory. I don't know if you've heard of Elon Musk.
Oh, he's a time traveler, yeah?
Definitely. But he firmly believes in a simulation.
Are you serious?
Correct.
Yeah.
But have you seen his girlfriend, whoever the fuck, Grimes? Her Instagram is the weirdest shit I've ever seen in my goddamn life.
Maybe she's great in bed.
Maybe she also believes in the simulation.
Maybe she's part of the simulation.
I'm just saying maybe they're both freaks. And I'm not talking about in the sex way. Maybe they're just...
Ever heard of Neil deGrasse Tyson?
Yes.
Simulation believer. They say more so than anything else that makes
sense. It's crazy. They say, like, because the fact that nature is all based on mathematics, like everything can be mathematically figured out. They're like, that's not nature. That's supposed to be based on mathematics.
It's supposed to be random, but it's not.
And there's a lot more to it, of course. I forgot most of the facts I read. I remember I believe it.
Well, there's things like the, what's it called? Like the code of numbers that you see, the chain. I can't remember what kind of numbers they're called. It's basically like when you add the last two numbers together, they're called like something numbers.
Oh, the fact that scientists have found like a defective code in nature where like they're like, what? Like, I don't even know how to explain that. And then I remember the shit that I read. The CIA actually released this, and it's an article how we're in it. Energy astral plane and how the law of attraction is real. That was published by the CIA, who I don't trust at all, but usually they keep that information to them to themselves. And you could Google that shit's gnarly. It's
Fibonacci
basically
numbers, sorry.
Okay. Just the law of attraction is real and published straight, not by the secret. If you're against, I'm all for all that shit, as you know.
Yes.
But like, this is just basically the CIA going, yeah, the secret's real. The law of attraction and teaching of Abraham or Abraham's, I don't even know. But you could Google that right there. I'll send you the
fascinating
link.
Fascinating.
It's weird.
Well,
Fibonacci numbers that I'm talking about are number sequences in nature. So let's see. Like in flowers, for instance, we see these different numbers. Fibonacci numbers are like this. So like the two last numbers get added together. So like one, then you have two, then you have three, then you have five, then you have eight, then you have 13 and so on and so forth. And so like in certain areas of nature, we see that only these Fibonacci numbers, like for example, on the petals of flowers, Most have 3 petals, 5 petals, 8 petals, 13 petals, 21 petals, 34 petals, 55 petals, or 89 petals.
It's a lot of petals.
Which are all just Fibonacci numbers and no other numbers. You also see like the spiral and like snails and stuff. That sequence is all Fibonacci numbers of the slow exponential growth of the spirals. And
you say why, right? Mm. Well, Elon Musk says that there's 1 in billions chance, scientifically, that we are not living in a computer simulation right now. And if we're not, at some point we will be because of where we're heading. Now, this is why a lot of the scientists firmly believe in this. 40 years ago, we had Pong on our, like, we literally, that was the game we had. Okay, now we have VR and AI. Yeah. They said the trajectory that which things have happened, like time-wise.
Sure, the exponential jump is unprecedented.
It doesn't make any sense. When you look at history, all of a sudden you'll see in the Roman times a crazy jump out of nowhere. They cannot make any logical sense of it, except that maybe we're being allowed certain things.
Yeah, I have wondered before, have we been at this level of advancement before?
Never.
How do we know?
Have you seen the pyramids of Giza and Teotihuacan? They still can't figure out how we built it.
Well, I don't know, though. Have you seen the YouTube videos of the guys building pools in the jungle? Because that's how we built the fucking pyramids.
Oh, my God. Those guys are amazing.
Well, have you seen the Ukraine pyramids that they found that were dated back to, like, dinosaur times under the ground? They found pyramids.
So that's why I wonder, what if there was, like, an insane natural disaster where we did actually have this level of technology before?
The truth is, we don't know shit about shit.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
Dinosaur time pyramids, that's crazy.
But then I think people definitely lived during the time of the dinosaurs.
Well, let's just say this.
But that may be my creationist upbringing coming out again.
I am a Christian. But this is the thing that's trippy, is there's different ideas of the simulation, right? So some people are like, aliens are the ones doing it. They're, you know, from a different part of the universe and they're controlling us simulation wise and blah, blah, blah. Some people believe, I believe it's Neil deGrasse Tyson, believes that advanced humans are controlling the simulation.
Okay.
So basically,
like Elon Musk?
Perhaps like Elon Musk.
Elon Musk said in an interview, his goal and what they're working on is to download our brains to the cloud and become one with AI. And he actually, what he says is he wants to do that so AI doesn't control us.
Yes.
So Terminator shit doesn't happen.
He's very anti-AI.
I feel like some people are going to hate this episode, but I don't care. What I was going to say too is that's
why did you say
I,
that?
Because
we're
I don't know. I feel
we're
like
mind
people,
fucking them. Imagine if you just believed in some shit.
No, people are going to be like, you guys are so full of shit, I think is what some people are
look
say.
At my aluminum bandana.
This is
you're
a conspiracy theory episode. We're just throwing out ideas, people.
Well, and
this
it's fun.
But I'm about to get real, actually. That's actually why I really liked Andrew Yang, because one of the big things of his platform is he wanted to appoint officials who were actually very well versed in like AI and in internet shit. And that one of his big things was like, we have all these old ass people controlling our government who don't even fucking can't even figure out how to upload a story on Instagram. We need people. We're in a race against China for AI. And if we get AI in the wrong people's hands, it's not going to be good. It is not going to be good. And so that was a big thing of his. And I'm like, damn, we actually do need government officials using their platform.
I always wondered why don't like scientists and run shit. Why don't the brightest minds in the world run shit?
Well, I guess they technically do behind the scenes.
It's always money and power.
We're just watching puppets. Mm-hmm. Puppets. Puppet masters.
I love that one of the modern conveniences of life nowadays is that there's a way to track almost everything. We're talking steps, heart rate, spending, career goals, screen time, whatever you want to track, there's pretty much an easy way to do it. But for so long, that wasn't the case with fertility. But why? Fertility is one thing you should be able to keep a close eye on, whether you're looking to expand your family or not. And that's why Modern Fertility was created. It is the easy and affordable way to test your fertility hormones at home with a simple finger prick. Simply complete the test and mail it in with the prepaid label. And within 10 days, you'll have your personalized results. You'll get insight into how many eggs you have, hormone levels, and any reproductive red flags. And the results go in depth into what every hormone means. And you can also talk, by the way, one-on-one with a fertility nurse to review your options or questions that you have, or talk about next steps if that's necessary. And it's always so comforting to be able to talk to a professional nurse about these questions. And if you've ever looked into having fertility tests done at a doctor's office, you know that they can cost over $1,000. It's not cheap. And with modern fertility, you'll pay a fraction of that. Just $159 for the exact same information, because modern fertility knows that fertility should be available to everyone easily and affordably. And if you want kids today or maybe one day, you're going to want that information to make the decision that's best for you. So right now, Modern Fertility is offering our listeners $20 off the test when you go to modernfertility.com/chatty. That means your test will cost $139 instead of the hundreds or thousands it could cost at a doctor's office. Get $20 off your fertility test when you go to modernfertility.com/chatty. That's modernfertility.com/chatty. Think about this. Let's just say we became so advanced, right? And then something started to happen, like crazy natural disasters or whatever. Something happened, climate change. Everything, the planet got all fucked up. Yeah. And future us, who are so advanced, AI, whatever it may be, wanted to then run simulations of 2020 to see and mess with stuff to try to prevent future problems.
Okay.
Right? So you're trying to, like, all of a sudden when there's these crazy fires in Australia, all right, out of nowhere, never happened that large before. Maybe someone outside of the simulation is trying to see, how do we handle a fire of this magnitude? Oh, hey, pandemic, how do we deal with a worldwide pandemic?
Hey guys, we're human beings. Can you leave us alone? I'm having a hard time over here.
Or are we? I don't know that you two exist. At the end of the day, this is all in my own brain. Maybe right now I'm strapped into something and I'm old and I want to live like a youthful life again, and you guys don't even exist. I'm paying for this experience.
You know what fucked me up was Black Mirror. I'm like, that's going to happen.
Yeah.
That's going to happen.
It took me down a horrible trail.
Dude, that one where they rate people on their social status, like
that
likes.
Was horrible.
That's happening in China.
Oh, totally.
Wait, what?
So in China, they have facial recognition.
Yeah.
And the thing is that you can get like points for or against, like you basically have like a government profile. And if you do something like bad, then you can get demarked, like down, marked down on
it's
your
like
facial
credit.
Recognition. So like sometimes you can't get into certain places if you like don't have enough. Yeah, exactly. Like
it's
don't
like
have
a
enough
credit
like social
score,
credit.
But it's like a human being score.
Yeah.
Like, oh, you're like, God, oh, you're so a shitty scary. Person. You don't listen to the government. You can't go in there. Like, you're like that.
That's
it's
so
crazy.
So you have a bad score. So you can't have access to certain things that other people do. And then you have to try to do good things to get your score back up.
Yeah.
It's basically it's like some of the ideas of Christianity, but then put in place in real life.
Put in digital format.
No shade. No shade. Just my experience of the religion. Not everyone's. Wow, but that's the thing though, right? If you think about that.
It's all possible.
But that's like, what the scientists say, they can't disprove it, right? So they can't disprove that we're not living in a simulation because they use the example of this. There's a few examples, right? If someone is raised in a cave their whole life and trapped and not let out of the cave, that's all the reality
of
that
course.
They know.
And they probably think if anyone else exists that they live in a cave too.
Exactly.
Sure.
Or then you can take it further, right? So I forget what philosopher it was, said that this was a long,
Friedrich
long time ago.
Nietzsche.
Yes, him.
Friedrich Nietzsche.
Nietzsche.
No, it was many, many, many moons ago. And someone said that if you have, let's just say, numerous prisoners who are born and living in like a dark prison in a cell, and that's all that they know are the people that are next to them. They're stuck in this prison. And every once in a while, they see shadows that go by once a day and they go, those are other people outside of the prison. Turns out there were no people. It's just something else, like a tree that's not alive. So when then we're talking about other things like, oh, but I feel like that makes sense and whatever. It's like, well, we really don't fucking know, do we?
Here's what I always come back to.
Huh?
Here's what I always come back to, because, you know, when I was growing up in my Christian homeschooled home, we were taught that like God made the earth in 5 days, like the Big Bang wasn't real, all that kind of thing. What I always came back to is I was like, why do I give a fuck? I don't give a fuck if the Big Bang brought us here or if God brought us here or whoever. How does that affect my life now? I don't care where we, I mean, I do, I would like to know where we originated, but realistically, it does not affect any of us today, knowing where we came from or whether we're in a simulation or not. Which brings me, did you guys watch Westworld?
No, I did not.
2 episodes. Both I heard like, it was good. Nah. It was good.
I'm hyperventilating. You need to watch it because the whole point of the show, for those of you who haven't seen it, is people go to this basically like Disneyland style resort where all these, they make robots that look, act, think everything just like humans, but it's like the Wild West. So you and Evan could show up and be right. Like, oh, we're going to chill at the brothel for the next 5 days. Yes. And it doesn't matter what we do because this is all fake.
It's all
right?
Fake. Sure.
Or we could shoot this person and next week they'll reboot them and they'll be back living again.
Yes.
But in the show, because these people are such complicated AI robots, everything they feel is the same as us. They feel the pain when they're shot. Mm-hmm. They feel the emotional stress when they're sexually assaulted, all these things, even though they're robots. So the whole thing, the question the show is posing is like, what is consciousness? What is sentience? Like, at what point do things have rights if they can feel the complex feelings that we do? Like, what makes us humans? And
that's where we're getting with AI.
So what about robot rights?
Robot rights. Do you know that there's a robot out right now that can get something done so fast that it's like it? You blink and like basically the robot could come in right now, kill you and leave, and you wouldn't even know that it was ever here because that's how fast it is.
I like that.
I would prefer to die that way.
I don't. I don't.
Jesus, we're dark, aren't we, Jess? Cool with me.
I'd like a fight for my life.
I'm tired of being in this house. Like, if I'm gonna go, chill.
I would prefer it to be quick. You know what I mean?
String me out, baby.
But that's the thing that's crazy is you wouldn't know that it was even here.
That's how fast this is the thing. Any technology they have 100 times that. Think about our goddamn iPhones, okay?
I'm sorry, I'm turning on the air. Evan, I apologize. The sound might get weird, but I'm dying.
Yeah, it's hot as balls in here. This hat is making me sweat, actually.
Your head's cooking like a baked potato. That's so funny.
Your head's cooking like a baked potato. Sorry for the sound, guys. We're turning on the air conditioning. Now, here's the thing. Think about our iPhones, okay? They have all the technology to make our iPhones last 200 hours.
Mm-hmm.
I can't think of any other better technology. That's the first thing that comes to mind. It's like a 200-hour battery. It could have been waterproof
10 years ago.
Mm-hmm. 120, maybe not 20. But the thing is, they've got to slowly release this. So one, it keeps us consumers wanting more. So we keep, you know, feeding the monster of capitalism. It's a cash cow. Of course. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's why, I mean, this isn't a conspiracy. If you have a vacuum from 1955, that shit probably still works. We had a vacuum for 30 years and a washer and dryer in 30 years in our house. You buy a vacuum recently, it's done in 6 months. Yep. Garbage falls apart. Trash.
I heard that the technology of the iPhone, though, is like the same as the computer that sent the first rocket to space.
Yeah,
oh, don't even get me started. You want to talk about conspiracy theory?
Yeah, let's talk about
something
that. Come here.
That I don't want to believe, the lunar landing being bullshit. I love space.
Oh,
I love astrology. I love crystals. I love all that shit. I want to go to the moon. I love that shit.
Mm-hmm.
So what's the point of this conspiracy? This is my question about the moon one. Why? Why fake the moon landing?
To bankrupt Russia because we were at a cold war with them and it essentially worked. It was propaganda. But that's not even why I believe it. I was literally turning a blind eye like, no, we went. And then I Googled, because someone told me, then how did we lose the technology to go there? If you Google it, NASA or whatever government officials say like, yeah, and they publish articles on explaining how we lost the technology to go to the moon. Yes.
What?
That's what made me go, Oh, come on. I really was trying to believe this shit. How the fuck can we advance? What was it, 60 years ago, 50 years ago?
Yeah.
How did we go? Everything else, the phone went forward. Cars went, everything. And yet, the technology we had to go to the moon is gone? Or they don't know. They lost it. They lost the tapes. They lost JFK's brain. Like, okay, government, come up with a little bit of better excuses than that.
Do you think that, what about like the theories about like assassinated by the government, like Bob Marley, like Tupac, that kind of thing?
I mean, I have no proof or evidence, but I find it very eerily weird that every person that is radically against the system,
the status quo
gets taken out at a very young age. And actually, I love John Lennon. I love the Beatles. And there's a documentary called The U.S. versus John Lennon. And the FBI was investigating John Lennon. And at that time, they typed on typewriters and there was a carbon paper behind it. So they, because of the Freedom of Information Act, they released the dossier, the reports on John Lennon, but they blacked everything out. But they're dumb fucks. They forgot about the carbon paper. So if you held the carbon paper up to the light, it showed everything. And the most powerful quote from the government investigating John Lennon said, "John Lennon represents peace and love, therefore is an enemy to the United States of America." And that's all on the books, folks. That's not theory. That's fucking fact. It goes against everything. We go to war. That's what we do. Back in the day, we would be like, they have oil. Let's get them. Now we can't do that. So we have the Gulf.
I mean, we killed Jesus, right?
Yeah.
It's been happening since the dawn of time.
It's just back in the day, they could just do it. Now they have to create reasons why. The Gulf of Tonkin was released by the government. That was the ship that was attacked in Vietnam that led us to the Vietnam War.
Okay.
They bullshit because of Nixon and the scandals. It's released by the government saying like, whoops, we lied about that. We were at war for 10 years. 200,000 American died. 2 million Vietnamese people died. Whoops. Whoopsie, you know what I mean?
Well, here's what I think too right now. I think what's going on right now too, it's no coincidence that now a whole group of people are being directed to say things like Black Lives Matter is a terrorist organization.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know if you know, we were talking about it, like the Boogaloo, you know, those guys.
The Boogaloo Boys.
You need to look up the Boogaloo Boys. They're people who wear Hawaiian, their signature thing is like Hawaiian shirts and tactical gear. And literally their whole thing is just to incite chaos, especially in things like the protests.
I went to a gang of protests and there's absolutely instigators and disruptors and you could just see it. They're not part of the Black Lives Matter movement.
Mm-hmm. And so when you have people inciting violence like that, how easy is it for the police state, for the government to go, these are terrorist groups, we must stop this. And then all of a sudden, crazy uses of force, crazy interventions are happening in these huge cities where protests are happening. It's gnarly.
I'm gonna say one thing. I'm gonna go off. And you know what? Sorry, I'm probably gonna get just gonna get laid out for this, but I have to say this, okay? A lot of people were wanting us to talk about QAnon. I'm gonna say one thing about QAnon.
Fucking say it.
Okay. So listen.
I'm sweating.
I understand that there are certain things that QAnon has talked about that are things of importance. Are you kidding me? All these child sex trafficking rings? It's so important. But movements can't become movements. Like you don't start off with something that's just like, here's a bunch of shit. Do you want to join this all bad stuff? Of course there can be truths in things and still the actual bones of it are fucking bad. And I'll say this about QAnon. Listen, this is not any judgment. If you are starting to like get into some QAnon stuff and maybe those are the things that kind of pulled you in.
Topics that actually matter
that are important. But I'm going to say this. It's not judgment. I understand we're in a weird time right now. We want answers. We want to protect our families and ourselves. But please, I beg you, before you dive deep into that shit, to realize the tentacles that are so deep in that are so racist and so anti-Semitic and so fucking alt-right. And it's really, really dangerous. That's all I'm going to fucking say about that shit.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, research before you just give your heart and soul away to something.
This is the thing that's so difficult, is that these super passionate, strong believers are saying, we've done our own independent research through QAnon. So it's becoming this super slippery slope where people are like, do your own research. And then it gets to the point where people literally do not believe anything they see in any form of mainstream media. And like, yeah, say you have a healthy skepticism for the things you see on TV. But when people are literally saying, I just don't believe any journalistic sources anymore because of what I've read on QAnon, it's like, you got to draw the line somewhere. You got to draw the line of skepticism somewhere,
listen,
I believe.
I'm coming out here talking about the birds aren't fucking real. Like, we're having a silly good time, okay? This is a silly good time.
And we're talking about serious shit too, but...
But in general, you know, we're having a good time. We're having a good time. But I just wanted to say that because I know personally for myself, I have some very wonderful people in my life who have very good hearts when I'm talking about the QAnon shit. And if you feel attacked, I'm not trying to fucking attack you, because I get that, especially anyone who listens to this podcast, it's a good heart and you're trying to figure out and you want to help in certain ways and get the word out. But all I'm saying, before you dive fully into something and start posting certain shit, just understand some of the roots of racism and anti-Semitism and all that.
Furthermore, the skewing of statistics to try to prove a point, and I would like to link this in the episode notes, a different podcast called You're Wrong About. They have one about Wayfair and human trafficking statistics. They have another one about QAnon, and they really break down, like, when you see these memes traveling around, some of them are just straight up made up stats, which is kind of scary because the internet is where people are getting all of their information. And when you're using alternate sources and no forms of fact checking, there's just straight up lies that are being spread around. And also there's some statistics where they're being skewed to make things look a different way. For example, they say there was 800,000 missing children in the US. That's actually just the number of children that are reported missing. Over 98% of those children are found. And a lot of times, most of them are like custody battles, for instance, where like a child's reported missing because like the other parent isn't, bringing them back to the so there's all these ways.
Of course, it is so important, but it's
right.
Just...
But when you're looking at the number, like I kept seeing people saying 800,000 children missing. Where are these children going? It's the Lib Dems who are using them for child sex trafficking. It's like, well, that number isn't even accurate because that's just children reported missing every year, most of whom which are it's custody battle shit. The number of ones that are actually being scooped up by strangers in the dark of night is the 1%. And I'm not saying that we shouldn't care about that, like one or less than 1%.
But that needs those children need to be fought for, absolutely.
But some of these numbers and statistics you have to understand are contextual.
Yeah.
It is scary because I went down that rabbit hole and I'm just like, oh, fuck. Yeah. I truly believe that some of it is true. And then some of it,
there's
like,
always a nugget of truth.
I'm like,
that
come on.
In.
Like what you said, they'll take that. Oh, that narrative. Okay, that part's true. We're going to spin it this way. Mm-hmm. And it's like, why did you do that? You took away from the fact that there are actual children kidnapped and God knows what.
Or abused in their own homes by their own family members and friends. That's the shit. That's
so crazy. Yeah, so and then it's like, why do you have to dilute that? It already was worth fighting for. And then you make up one lie about something that's true. And then people on the other side will completely dismiss it. You're like, no.
Yes.
There
or
are
why
children.
Do you have to use it as a red herring when we're in the middle of fighting as a country for certain rights and then throw it up like, well, why don't we care? You know, I kept seeing the hashtag children's lives matter. And it's like the 100% they do. But why are we using this as some sort of...
That's why I love... I almost said Keanu. Kelso. Fucking... What's his name?
From That 70s Show?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Yes,
he
yes,
is
yes.
A
Ashton Kutcher. Ashton Kutcher.
He's a super big
Follow
advocate.
Him and like Blake Lively. And they are... all about stopping human trafficking, which is real, which is happening all the time. Maybe not as much as the QAnon people may say, but it is fucking happening.
Of course.
There's crazy shit on the dark web.
And the beauty of social media and the internet is that it's making things more like come to light more and more aware. We're more aware of everything now than like 20 years ago. You know, it might have looked different if people would have known about Epstein online. People might have been posting more and all that shit.
Yeah.
But then at the same time, like you're saying, Bekah, with the internet, then all of a sudden people are throwing out numbers that aren't necessarily true.
Or just completely not true.
All I'm saying is this, is that we talked about it in the Jessica Lanyato episode. It's all about checking. It's all about going back to the resources, right? So I've been sent some things before that's like, oh my God, this is horrific. And it's true and needs to get out there. And it's, that's completely factual. But then when I go back to where the source is actually coming from, it is from some dangerous alt-right shit. And it's just something before you dive in, just to be aware of. I just wanted to put that out there.
Yeah. And the last thing I want to say on this, which I've said a lot on my social media platforms, but these are just facts. These are just facts we're spitting. I know one of the major theories by QAnon is that Trump is a savior who is trying to stop these child sex trafficking rings. And I just want to come with the facts. There are literally dozens of people who have accused him of sexual assault. And of course, people can say this is part of the conspiracy. They're trying to take him down now after the election. Many of these accusations happened far before the election. His own wife in a 1993 divorce trial has a whole story about how he brutally raped her, and other people have similar stories. This is shit way before the 2016 elections, when he was just a celebrity TV person.
That motherfucker is raping his own wife.
Yeah,
this is insane.
So it's like there's plenty of shit on. I don't know. It really bothers me. There's a girl who was 12 years old at the time who alleges that Trump raped her at an Epstein party, and there are quotes from Trump in the early 2000s saying, Epstein is a wonderful guy. I've known him for so long. And there's actually a specific quote where he said, it's been said that he also appreciates beautiful women like myself, some on the younger side. This is something he said about Epstein in the early 2000s. He has plenty of ties to Jeffrey Epstein and plenty of...
Yes.
Just like, come on, guys. Come on. Come on.
Yeah. Anyways, back in.
All right. So we're
what about them crows?
Those crows, guys. Well, speaking of the moon from earlier, there are a lot of people who actually don't even believe the moon exists, Craig. There's no moon.
I like the moon.
There's no moon.
It helps with my menstrual cycle.
The moon is definitely fucking real.
I want to go to the moon.
Don't even come for the moon.
I still kind of believe we went to the moon, but like I said, we lost the technology.
It has always blown my mind that we had that technology in the 50s.
Yes, indeed. Yeah. Doesn't make a lot of
government,
sense.
Hey, government, lie better, please. I want to go to the moon.
Make it a little more believable.
Come on.
Yeah, you had one channel on TV, but we could go to the moon.
But this is the thing.
Exactly.
This is the thing. Does Neil Armstrong, for instance, does he actually believe he landed on the moon?
I don't know. I don't want to know.
Because they could potentially like simulate something where people actually thought they were getting in a rocket ship and actually thought that they were headed to the moon.
I kind of want to be like the Matrix. It's like, just give me the blue pill.
But that's
I want to believe
that moon. The moon is basically a hologram in the sky. There's a man who claimed that he looked at it for an entire year, stared at the moon for a whole year, which sounds very exhausting.
That sounds like a tweaker. I'm just going to put that out there. Sounds like a big old tweaker. I didn't blink once.
This is also David, I believe it's David Icke. Some people say Ike. I think
it's Ike. Is anyone else sweating in these?
I'm dripping sweat.
That's why I did the bandana.
Smart.
But David Icke is one of the ones who believes that the moon is just a hologram. And this is also a reminder, I'm sorry to go back to what we were just talking about, but a lot of the stuff that we're talking about in QAnon, a lot of the foundations are a lot of things that David Icke believes. David Icke believes the moon is a hologram. He also believes in lizard people. Okay, so just something to remind yourself.
What the fuck are lizard
people? And I also think he believes that the earth is hollow. I could be wrong about that one, but the lizard people?
Why does it matter if the earth's hollow or not? I'm so confused by all of this.
I am too.
Who has time for this
Who's
shit?
Who's dug that deep to where they would really know? Honestly, though. How the fuck do we know?
I mean,
it could be hollow. It could not be hollow.
Listen, broads, the world may be weird right now, but one thing we do know is that summer is turning into fall, which is hard to believe since most of the country is currently in the middle of a heat wave. I know, that's why our cameras are shutting down during this episode. But before you know it, we will be trading in our flip-flops for sneakers and flats, which of course means I am scouring the Rothy's website often to find my new fall go-to shoes and bags. Their products are a favorite around here for a lot of reasons, but at the top of the list, they're unbelievably sustainable. That's right. Rothy's shoes are seamlessly knit with thread made from plastic water bottles. Yes, you heard that right. Plastic water bottles. It's amazing. So far, Rothy's has kept over 50 million single-use bottles out of landfills and transformed them into their signature thread, which is knit into their products. Plus, they own and operate their own manufacturing shop, so sustainability is prioritized every step of the way. I already know my go-to will be the same as last fall because the shoe is just that good. God, I love their sneakers so much. But also, I'm talking about that best-selling style that they have, the Point in black, which has over 3,000 almost perfect reviews and goes with everything. They're definitely a closet staple for me. And they're so comfortable. Like, I don't think I can emphasize that enough. We all know they're cute. We know they're sustainable. The comfortability was what blew my mind when I first put on my first pair of Rothy's. They're the most cozy. And they also have tons of different styles, colors, and prints that are constantly changing, and they're adding and selling out. So you're going to want to hop on the website. And by the way, if you need a refresh after you find yourself wearing them every day, because you will wear them every day, they're totally machine washable. So you just toss them in like you would your regular loads and they'll come out looking good as new. So check out all the amazing shoes and bags available right now at rothys.com/chatty. That's rothys.com, rothys.com/chatty. Style and sustainability meet to create your new favorites. Head to rothys.com/chatty today. And speaking of comfort, let's talk about sleep. If there's one area of your life that is absolutely worth investing in right now, it's your sleep. Between the current climate, the fears of health, job security fear, and all the other regular stressors of life, it's honestly a surprise any of us are sleeping at all. Let Helix Mattress be the saving grace of your sleep, because if you're anything like me, you need all the help you can get, especially right now. Helix knows that every body is unique, which means every mattress needs to be unique. One size fits all definitely does not apply here. I don't know why they've always said that about the mattresses, okay? Helix doesn't believe that. Helix knows. Start off by going to helixsleep.com/chatty to take their 2-minute sleep quiz so you can figure out your body type and sleep preference, and it can be matched to your perfect mattress type. Soft, firm, side, back, stomach sleeper. There's a unique mattress out there that is exactly what you need to get your best night's sleep. I took the quiz, got my perfect match, and I'm going to be real with you. The Helix mattress changed my life. I tend to sleep on my side, and the way that I would sleep, the type of mattress that I have, I would always wake up with a horrible neck and back ache. And guess what? Now with Helix, it's not so. I'm sleeping oh so wonderfully, waking up feeling fresh. I'm telling you, investing in your mattress is an absolute game changer. I have honestly never slept better. Helix was even awarded the number one mattress pick the last 2 years by GQ and Wired magazine. So, you know, it's good. And you also, I'm telling you, it's amazing. It's the best. And you can feel 100% secure purchasing your new mattress because each one comes with a 10-year warranty and a 100-night trial risk-free. So get your best night's sleep now. Helix is offering up to $200. $200 off all mattress orders and 2 free pillows that they're throwing in for our listeners at helixsleep.com/chatty. That's Helix, H-E-L-I-X, sleep.com/chatty for up to $200 off. helixsleep.com/chatty. And you know you're going to want to get a good night's sleep after listening to this episode. Woo! helixsleep.com/chatty.
It could not be Hollywood.
Well, that's what always blows my mind is apparently that theory's not... That theory is actually incorrect about there being lava at the core.
Man,
oh, really?
Liquid hot magma.
Is it ice? Water. No, they think it's water.
Oh, nice. They we need that, California.
This is like
dig deep.
This is like a new theory. Deep. Instead of it being like lava, like a hot stuff that's making things shift with the tectonic plates, apparently the new theory is that the plates are actually on water. And that's why they can
I like
shift.
That better.
To all the people like taking everything as the word of the Lord, even though a lot of people don't believe in the Lord. But you know what I mean? Remember tobacco when they said it was fine?
Mm-hmm.
Remember asbestos when they said it was fine?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Remember GMO when they say it's fine? Get the fuck out of here. Mm-hmm. There's so much shit. Like, it's like, do we really know? No, I mean, but look, none of us know. No.
People didn't, if this is the dumbest thing to bring up, people didn't really have peanut allergies, like, however many years ago. Now everyone and their mother, including myself and my sister, has a fucking peanut allergy because of how many times it's been
like, you know,
synthesize or genetically engineer. Yeah.
Yeah. Talking like we're scientists. None of us. Three of us don't know fucking shit.
Listen. Okay. For the record, we don't know shit, but we're also dropping some truth gems here. Okay. Okay.
Listen, at the end of the day, do I barely have my degree in communications? Yes.
Did I go to college for one semester to sell drugs and meet a lot of contacts? Yes. Community college. Let's be clear.
I'm still trying to finish community my college. Art degree, so.
Well, let's be clear.
Do I have passionate beliefs in some of this? Maybe. Maybe it's all just fun and games, but all I know is that maybe we're in a simulation.
That's and why not, crows you know? Are smart as fuck.
I know that I am breathing right now. I can feel the breath in my lungs. I don't know if Becca and Craig are real or not. I'm not 100% sure, but I know that crows are real and they are super smart.
What about like psychics? Do you ever trip out on that shit? Like what you were saying? Like,
yeah, that shit's weird.
How do psychics, like we had Jessica on and she literally predicted that there would be an airborne plague, like she called it.
First of all, I didn't believe in that shit before I went, for the record. I was a skeptic.
I believe in 100%.
And then I went and I was like, what the fuck, lady? Like this is before Instagram, before anything.
And she didn't know who the fuck
she
you were.
She didn't know who the fuck. I came up with my sister's reading. My sister didn't talk about me. She's like, oh my God, your brother's in trouble, huh? And she's like, yeah, what the fuck? And like, you need to bring him in. He's like, he's broke. I'll read him for free. He's going to fucking die. And then she was like, how the fuck? And all the skeptics out there, I'd be like, go to a legit one. Just like there's good lawyers and good mechanics.
Look
and
them up on Yelp.
There's bad lawyers and bad mechanics. Mm-hmm. The same thing in the psychic world. Go to a good one.
What a good example.
That was a fantastic analogy.
So true. Yeah. I never even thought about it like that either. Read the reviews.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yelp that reviews. Shit blew my fucking mind. I was like, what? How'd you know it was a pill popper?
It's
there's one in your mouth right now, asshole. Oh.
You literally can't look me straight in the eyes right now.
You put a whole handful of them on the desk before we started the session.
How did she know? They're falling out of my pocket as I pull out $3 for her. Oh, that's a Skittle. That's a white Skittle in the oblong shape. It's a mince. MYNTZ. Good. Trader Joe's. $1.39.
I do have one that I do want to bring up because it hooked me in. There are so many other ones that, you know, we could talk about.
We've really gone down some rabbit trails today.
We could talk about the Mandela effect. We could talk about, you know, the fact.
Mandela effect is weird.
That's weird.
But that shit's weird.
But they connect that to it being a simulation because they believe that it's a glitch in the simulation. Okay, and by the way, they can date it back to the exact date of when the simulation glitched.
So the Mandela effect just really began. Quickly cover the Mandela effect for those who don't know what it is. Do you think it's crazy?
So basically the whole concept of the Mandela effect started 2010. This one like author or something brought up the fact that she ended up seeing that Nelson Mandela was still alive. And she was like, no, I swore that I watched Nelson Mandela's funeral. I saw his wife give a emotional speech. It was this whole thing that I watched. I swear to God, I watched it on TV. She ended up finding out that all these other people were like, same. I watched the funeral. Nelson Mandela died. And it's like, no, he's actually still alive. Nelson Mandela, I believe, passed away in like 2013 or something. And this was in 2010. And so then this whole concept of the Mandela effect, that's what they call it, that started where people are convinced, for instance, the one that fucked my brain up.
Bernstein Bears. Yeah.
So read those books my entire life, watched the show my entire life, know that it's spelled at the end, S-T-E-I-N, Bernstein. Well, turns out apparently the whole entire time it was Bernstein. And I was like, no.
Yeah, I was like, no.
No.
But these are Jewish bears.
I was like, no. They're the Bernstein bears.
You're wrong.
These are not the Bernstein bears. Well, I found my old books, my old tattered books, Bernstein bears. And I'm like, no, it's just not possible.
No, the Bernstein Bears.
And there are so many examples of the Mandela effect.
Shazam and yes. Shaq and Sinbad.
That movie like, never existed.
What?
Okay.
At all?
No. So.
I was like, oh, I just got fucked again.
Yes.
I was like,
okay,
what? Wait.
Hold
what?
On.
What
Hold
is
on.
This one?
Okay. So we all have memories of this movie called Shazam, right?
I don't. I'm You're a little younger than you guys. Younger.
Okay. Well, this Big movie called 90s. Shazam, and I remembered Sinbad being it.
I did
it,
too.
Right? Okay. Yeah. Well, that movie never existed.
It was Shaq.
It's Shaq, and the movie's called Kazam.
Oh, fuck. I forgot. I didn't even remember that detail. Yeah.
And
we're in a simulation. Oh, I'm going to go pet a crow. This is bullshit, man. I got to pee. I want
to
go home.
You don't really need to pee. That's part of the simulation.
Why am I wet?
So they say they can date it back to an actual moment when they think shit went awry. I did not know about this until earlier when I was researching it. So apparently in Switzerland, which of course I am a Swiss citizen. Those motherfuckers are shady. We all are. But they discovered it. It's hard to break down and explain because I don't even know any of the words. But they basically figured out that they could create the same type of effect via certain fucking neutrons and whatever that the Big Bang, like that happened with the Big Bang. So they're like, all these scientists in Switzerland, they're like, we're going to do this. And I guess in September of 2008, it got out that they were going to do this and that they believed they had the technology to do this in a lab, a small version. And people started freaking out. They're like, no, you can't do the Big Bang shit. This is going to fuck with everything. What if there's a huge explosion? What if it starts fucking messing with shit? And people They did it anyways. Nothing happened. They got what they wanted, the same thing, like whatever happened, like chemically or whatever.
Neutrons
and all that type of science shit. I'm a communications major. happened. But then nothing else. Well, since then.
Weird shit.
Mandela effect. People are talking about all these weird shit.
YouTube video on this kid that was, he's like Albert Einstein as a kid, this child genius prodigy. And he talks all about that and uses all these words that I couldn't even understand. Mm-hmm. He's literally like playing with her Rubik's cubes while like just talking about it and just spitting this shit. Yeah. And he's like, and that's when the space-time continuum was altered and they fucked up reality. And I was just like, and it's, you could Google it, look it up. I don't even know what it's called, but the shit you explore when you're a stoner, let me tell you, you know,
yeah.
But I just remember thinking, like, how is this kid saying these words? And I struggle with basic conversation. And it was just a trip. His dad was asking him questions because he was a bright man, too, and saying, like, you know, if this, then what? And he was just explaining it. And it was just shit. It was that stuff.
Yeah.
He's like, they fucked it up. And we don't even know what they fucked up. Like, it's unknown. It's just like, why do we always have to play God? Hey. Just let the weather be the weather. Why are you going to make clouds?
Yep.
What are you doing up there? Leave it alone.
Well, apparently they kept doing it. They did it numerous times.
Oh, thanks, guys. Thanks.
Right. And so what you know, some of the theories are like, did they figure out that little things were glitching and shifting? Like universe, like certain people were left behind and weird little things were glitching. That then were they able to harness it and control certain things? Like maybe Nelson Mandela did die, but they were able to reset it so that he didn't die and all those crazy theories.
I completely forgot something that I learned during quarantine. Conspiracy theory was a term coined up by the CIA during the JFK assassination because there was so much shit going on. They were like, we got to shut these people up. Let's make them look like loonies. And the CIA made that phrase up.
Well, there's some conspiracy theories that have actually come true, such as Watergate. That started as a conspiracy. I don't know if you know that. But obviously, we now know that it was all true.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Listen, there's a lot of, I was deep diving into the conspiracy theories, and there's a lot of crazy ones, a.k.a. birds aren't real, a.k.a. the moon is a hologram. There's a lot of the lizard people. There's a lot of crazy batshit stuff out there. But there's also some that are, you scratch your head at a little bit.
You're like, and oh, fuck.
Now, there was...
Do you guys think Bush did 9/11?
Oh, man, I don't want to go down that
shit. I can't even go down that one.
I'm just going to ask.
I actually listened to a conspiracy theory expert, so I do want to have this expert on. He was on H3 breaking down these conspiracy theories.
I would like to have an expert on to talk about some of the more political pieces because I'm just going to sound like an idiot and probably fuck up a lot of stuff.
I don't want, because too many people died and I don't want to hurt anyone. But what I am going to say is, how the fuck is there 0 to 1 footage of the Pentagon getting hit? Ask yourself that question. the most fortified building on the planet, or one of the most fortified surveilled buildings on the planet, mm-hmm. had one video.
Mm-hmm. I always forget about the Pentagon thing.
Yeah,
too.
They got hit too.
Mm-hmm.
You think? Why isn't there? I always forget about that.
Where's the security footage? You're the fucking security of our nation.
Is there really only one video footage?
Yeah. Yeah, you could Google that shit. Yeah. There's one little hazy, weird video. It's like, okay, what about the thousands of cameras and you know what I mean?
That's bizarre.
How the fuck does Walmart have more surveillance footage of their parking lot than you?
To catch all the Karens outside with all that video footage.
Like,
come
that,
on.
I'm just going to throw that out there and let the people answer that question for themselves.
Yes.
And I'm not going to say what I believe.
There's a lot of crazy shit going on.
Not a conspiracy theory? Sorry, I just saw this on my phone while I was in the bathroom. Yes. Sorry to interrupt. Donald Trump is actually admitted in an interview that he is going to curb funding to the U.S. Postal Service to curb mail-in voting.
Yeah, that's real. No, that's
I said it before and I'll say it again. Is like, how the fuck are we going to have Space Force and I can't mail in a vote? Like, mm-hmm. how are we going to shoot laser beams?
Why can't we do Narnia? It securely on the internet yet? Is what I want to know.
We could solve all of our problems.
That definitely sounds like a lot of voter fraud opportunity.
I mean,
here
comes the cricket again.
Cricket.
It's Donald.
Is it real? Donald's like, okay, shut up.
Listen, there's a lot of wild shit out there. There's the Denver airport. That's something we could talk about at a different time. The Denver airport is wild.
Speaking of lizard people, there's like lizard people like corralling children in that airport.
The art of that airport is so fucking dark. And
it's a beautiful airport.
No, it's not. It's a scary airport.
It's very scary. And there's also, if you talk to like the people who actually work there, they're like, yes, there are 5 stories underneath the airport. This cost about $6.8 billion to build.
But wasn't it built like when they already had a fully functioning airport?
Didn't Obama get put down there? That's where he lives now. No, I'm just kidding.
Wait, what?
No, like some president got rushed to the Denver airport.
Oh, I don't know about that.
For safety?
I guess.
I mean, maybe there's a bunker down
there.
All
I know is that outside of the Denver airport, there is, you know, as many airports have, there's like the big plaque or stone to dedicate it to the people who spent the money on it. And it is a full Freemason symbol and it's all Freemasonry all over it. And that's just out there in the open. And all I'm going to say...
That shit is so weird. Why are the cops Freemasons and almost all of them?
Are they?
Yeah, they have all the patches. I learned that from Ice Cube, actually.
Some of my ancestors were in the Freemasons, and maybe that's how I got on The Bachelor.
I think that's definitely how you got on The Bachelor.
Everything is certain levels to it, too. Like, I'm sure there's tons of Freemasons that are absolutely good-hearted and join it because they do good things. They feed homeless. They do this. But then when you get to a certain level, I think just these places turn dark and weird and shit.
Well, there's Bohemian Grove.
Bilderberg Group, the Trilateral
Guys,
Commission,
Skull and Crossbones,
the Esoterics, the Popes.
Britney Spears.
You know what I thought?
We're gonna have to talk about the Britney Spears.
Oh my God,
Guys,
I love her.
We have to talk about
part two. What about, you just made me think of Catholic religion. I remember I thought of Sinead O'Connor ripping a picture of the Pope and they canceled her. But then the Catholic Church gets caught with thousands of cases of pedophilia and nobody cancels the church. Why didn't they get canceled?
Real shit.
You canceled Sinead O'Connor? She's a diva. She's a fucking badass. Have you heard her shit?
She's fantastic.
Oh my God.
You know that I want to shave my head because of her on a daily basis.
So hot.
She got canceled for ripping a paper, and the church doesn't get canceled for molesting children, and then they don't even, the priests don't even go to prison. They just get moved to another area. They pay deep pockets.
Listen.
It's crazy.
You got a lot of
shit. I don't want to die. I'm just joking.
I know,
I'm a comedian.
I know. We're going to get... If by the way, I'm putting this out there, if something happens to one of us...
I'm not suicidal.
I
have a cat.
This is... putting it out there right now. We're happy. We're healthy. Please be aware.
I got a rock in my pocket.
And I just want to... I got to end it on one final
Guys,
one.
Guys, we have to all write this in our journals tonight and text our friends.
We have to text our friends.
I'm in a good place.
Yes, we should write up a sign right now and hold it and then take photo evidence and put it all out there. But I want to wrap it with one because I heard this one. I'd never heard it before.
Do you think Chris Harrison is a lizard person?
I think Chris Harrison is part of the Illuminati.
I don't know who Chris Harrison is.
I bet
is.
He's a Freemason.
Bachelor.
Bachelor host, hello. Yeah.
Chris Harrison's definitely
there's some
a
weird
person.
Shit. Oh, wait, sorry. One more thing.
Yes.
JFK.
He's trying to wrap us.
Okay.
Oh, no, I'm trying to wrap for rapping. You guys. No.
JFK, the speech that supposedly got him killed, assassinated, was he said, He was talking about secret societies, and I bust out my rock. I was like, I'm not suicidal. I got an amethyst. It's pretty green. It's four really bucks. Pretty. House of Intuition on Melrose.
Oh, love.
I love that place. So anyways, you can look it up. Just Google speech that got JFK killed. And he says how he wants to basically the word secrecy is repugnant. And he talks about secret societies and how we need to shed a light on them and dismantle them. And why is the CIA secret? And then all of a sudden he gets a bullet to the head. I mean, you could Google that shit. It's just weird. It's just weird shit. I don't know, man.
I was raised by a conspiracy theorist. It's part of my being. My mother has raised me being like, don't trust anyone.
It's sad. It's just the Federal Reserve isn't federal. No, it's private.
The Federal Reserve started on whatever island.
Jekyll Island. And Woodrow Wilson signed it over. We don't own it's just the Rothschilds, the J.P. Morgans, the Chase, all that shit. It's
and
just
by
big
the way,
money.
That's not
big
some crazy
money.
QAnon stuff. That's a fact. That's how the Federal Reserve started. Just these are facts.
Yeah, that's
this
not
is
even
facts that are coming out right now. This is not.
We don't
theory.
Monitor our money system.
Well, yeah, like we were actually just talking about the Great Depression the other day and how individuals bailed out the country was so in debt to individuals such as. Can't remember any of their names.
Two.
But.
Anonymous.
That stuff, you know?
Well.
You feel me? That stuff?
That stuff? I mean, I feel it deep in my bones.
Oh, man.
I'm going to start my own Bitcoin. Call it Amethyst.
I like that.
Just start passing around crystals. I'll become part of that.
They're happy.
I'll become part of that.
Yeah.
Monetary system. Okay, I got it. Before we wrap, I have to tell all
Can
of you about...
Can we actually do another episode? Because I want to talk about the Denver airport.
We need to talk about the Denver airport. We need to talk about Brittany. We need about the lizard people. But I want to talk about the Dyatlov Pass.
I'm sorry?
The Dyatlov Pass, okay? And I want to talk about this because we're going to end this. And you're all going to want to look up videos on this, and it's something that I feel like I hadn't heard of before, and there's some great videos on it. So the Dyatlov Pass incident. Okay,
blow my mind. I'm ready.
This happened in there were 9 Russian hikers that died in the northern Ural Mountains in the early 60s under uncertain circumstances.
Okay? Where was it? Sorry, I'm not a good auditory learner.
The Ural Mountains in Russia.
Okay.
Nine hikers. Died. Okay. 60s. So basically, they found, when they went back to find their bodies, they found that they had set up camp. By the way, it's negative 40 degrees at nighttime there. And the tents had been cut open from inside. So they were escaping their own tents. Again, negative 40 degrees. 2 of the bodies were found right close by. They were only in their long underwear, no shoes. Okay. They had, the way that they died, they said frozen to death. Okay. And the others that were found were in very, like the clothing was very, not conducive. No, not conducive. Everyone was escaping, right? So then the other bodies seemed to be frozen, except there were a few that had blunt force trauma that had died from, and I'm talking brutal, and they said it is not possible that a human nor a human with a weapon could inflict those wounds onto the skull and the bodies. And then one of the bodies was found with no eyes and another was found with no tongue.
The boogeyman, Bobo Yaga.
So
Kukui.
They said maybe it was an animal natural disaster. It was like, okay,
the eyes and the tongue
and they said again a human couldn't inflict. And then also, if it was an animal, the bodies were not like eaten. It was very specific, and again, it was blunt trauma that didn't make any sense. Okay, so now this is 1959. Russia was like, yeah, it was a natural disaster, maybe an animal. The people wouldn't let it go. 2019, officially, the case has basically been reopened because people are so like up in arms about it. So they're talking about it again. They've talked about UFOs. I guess there's a lot of UFO shit over in Russia that the citizens have seen. And they talk about how a lot of the wounds inflicted look like almost when there are like high powered laser, like hot going through.
Okay, what, do they still have these bodies or something?
This is
my thing.
I didn't go full deep into this, and I'm going to be watching a movie on it later tonight, so I wanted to leave you all with that.
This is my thing. I always wonder, like, you know, what's the law that basically, it's the most simple explanation. What if it's just the autopsy person?
Coroner?
Yeah, the coroner. Yeah. That's right.
Got one. Right? Believe everything I said.
The coroner, what if they just had some coroner that was just off his rocker and was like, humans can't inflict this kind of trauma. And he didn't know what the fuck he was talking about.
No, because they have photos and everything. And you will see when you watch the videos that again? It's called the Dyatlov Pass. It's spelled Dyatlov Pass, a.k.a. the Devil's Pass. Mm. And the hike was started by a man named Igor Dyatlov. And it was a bunch of people, I believe, who were actually from university. Oh, I forgot the biggest part.
What?
On one of the bodies was found excessive amounts of radiation.
Yeah, this shit's weird, man. The truth is, there's so much we have no clue what is going on.
I can't believe I forgot that part. Yes. So why does one of the bodies, by the way, not all of them, one excessive radiation found on them?
I don't know, but The X-Files is no, they based were, on a true story.
Dead. They were found dead after stripping off clothes and fleeing through woods.
Yeah, this is the wild world we live on. We want to explore space. How about we figure out what we're doing here?
Can we figure out what happened in the Dyatlov Pass is all I'm asking. Christ
Wait, almighty. Apparently as of July 2020, this came out this year, they said they solved the case.
Uh-oh.
Yes, they said they officially solved the case and nobody's believing they came out and said. They said it was basically them just trying to quiet the people. So
they were killed by hypothermia. Then why would they have stripped off their clothes?
Why would they have tried to escape from the inside of their tents? Why is there radiation on their bodies? Why is there blunt force trauma?
It was some strong acid. No, I don't know.
Yeah, we know. They were all very high.
This is the crazy thing. They said that they died from hypothermia after they fled in terror and ran through the snow a mile or so down the mountain from their tents, not having time to dress after their tent had been mysteriously slashed from the inside. So they just died of hypothermia after all those things
and
happened.
All the blunt force trauma and the no tongue and the no eyes.
After either a Yeti or perhaps an alien ate their friend, they died from hypothermia.
And covered them in radiation.
Yeah, completely normal. Maybe
one of those bodies got sucked up by a UFO and then dropped back down, and maybe that's why it's covered in some sort of...
Oh my God.
Scary. Yeah, the tongue and eyes were... Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So dive into that one.
Fractured skulls and chest injuries.
Yes, and you should see the chest injuries. They are intense.
I don't
want to
see. I don't.
A leading Russian doctor claimed the injuries were likely the result of a big creature.
Yeti. Oh, Bigfoot.
Good coolers. Good brand.
Okay, well, thank you for the rest of my day will be devoted to this.
You're welcome.
I'll be watching that on the freeway home.
You're welcome.
For real. Okay, well.
Oh, great.
Well, I mean, here we are. I'd like to make another asterisk again. We are three, I don't even know, non-graduated fucktards talking about shit.
Yeah.
But we asked some good questions.
We're thinkers, you know.
We're just trying to think. Don't sign any documents because of this. You know, don't. Quote
people just
me.
Fly and don't riot quote. At the Denver airport. Let us below. Yeah. Like, ouch.
Don't quote me, but don't not quote me is all I'm going to say. Well, Broads, Craig, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
It was just necessary to see your beautiful face.
Thank you, ladies, so much. I love you.
It was fantastic.
Love you both.
Say it
love
to the camera.
Too.
I love you both. I am going to run. I have to pee-pee so bad. Yep. I drank a lot of water.
Go pee, Craig.
Okay.
All right, Broads. We'll chat soon.
Oh, my.